Hi, my name is Zach Plunkett with AtlasRFIDStore.com, and I'm going to talk about the different types of RFID tags used in race timing. Timing races with RFID is one of the most efficient and effective ways to get start times, finish times, and other important data from road races, marathons, triathlons, and other types of races. When you decide on using RFID for your race, there are several different options to choose from, such as the type of system, type of hardware, and the type of RFID tags to use. Today, we're going to talk specifically about the different types of RFID tags that are available for race timing and when to use one versus another. There are three main types of RFID tags that can be used in race timing: wet and laser labels, foamback tags, and specialty tags. Let's first talk about wet inlays and labels. Wet inlays and labels are thin, flexible tags with a plastic or paper face and are generally the most inexpensive type of tag that can be used for race timing. Inlays and labels are used for road races, marathons, 5Ks, cycle races, or any race where water is not a factor. This is because these tags are basic and do not contain any casing, which would allow them to be rugged or water resistant. Inlays and labels are placed on runners' bibs either vertically or horizontally, depending on the setup and polarization of the RFID antennas. They can also be placed on the number plate or helmet during cycle races. Because these tags are relatively inexpensive, sometimes two tags are placed on each bib to try and maximize read rates. Another advantage to using inlays and labels is that they can be printed on and encoded with RFID printers in-house, which makes them a great option for do-it-yourself race timers. Next are foamback tags. These are essentially wet inlays with a plastic face and a foam spacer on the back to mitigate any interference from water in the human body. The 4 millimeters of foam provides enough space between the runner and the tag to increase read rates and efficiency. Because more materials are used, foamback tags typically cost around twice as much as inlays or labels. Foamback tags are placed on bibs for marathons, road races, 5Ks, and any other racing event that will not be subjected to water. These tags cannot be printed in-house. However, vendors with specialized printers can print and encode these tags. Sometimes this added service is included in the tag cost, and sometimes there is an additional fee. Foamback tags are typically delivered pre-printed and encoded. The last group of tags for use in race timing is specialty tags. Under this category, there are a few different tag types intended for specialty races. Here are a few examples. Shoe tags. These are used on participants' shoelaces in road races. Strap tags. These are used in triathlons because they are water resistant and go on participants' ankles. Hard tags. These are also used in triathlons to strap to participants' ankles. Hard tags are usually water resistant and very rugged, enabling them to survive in events like mud races or obstacle courses. Specialty tags do not come on rolls like inlays, labels, and foamback tags, so the printing and encoding process is done manually, one tag at a time, and at an additional cost. Specialty tags are the most expensive of the three categories. Some, such as hard tags, are reusable, which could cut down on the overall costs when spread out over multiple races. Thanks for watching this video about types of RFID tags for race timing. For more information on RFID and how it's being used all over the world, check out our blog and our RFID resources page. And as always, if you have any questions at all, please send us an email or give us a call.